Hey guys, it's Aaron. We've been looking at live components recently. They're the, as of right now, as of this recording, the new release from SketchUp Labs. And I just thought it would be cool to look a little bit into how live components behave once you actually get them into a model, because they are components, kind of. So they kind of work the way components do, but not completely. So that's why I figured we should take a look at it. If it's that hard to describe exactly what it is, then it's worth a video, right? So let's take a look at using live components inside your model right now. All right, so I have a model and I got two things in here. I got Sumele and I have a live component that I downloaded. So the first thing I wanna look at before well, here, let me prove to you what this is, because one thing you should keep an eye on is if I click on Sumele over here, it tells me in my entity info that this is currently a component. This one right here, if I click on the toilet, it does tell me it is a live component and what the name of the definition is. If you don't already do it, I do recommend keeping entity info open. It flickers a little bit, it'll resize based on the thing you have picked, but man, so much good information in there, names, definitions, that kind of thing, that it's worth keeping open. As well as the configure button. So right there, I can actually configure this. So here's the first thing about live components. Live components cannot be scaled using the scale tool. Let me show you what I mean by that. Well, you probably already figured this out. If I hit scale and I hover over Sumele, I can click on her, I get the handles, I can make her whatever size I want. Live components, if I come over here, and let's get off of Sumele, and then I'm gonna hit this. When I hover over the toilet, see a little no comes up there, a little anti symbol. No scaling this component. So I can click as many times as I want. It's not gonna work. If I try pre-selecting and then hitting scale, it's just gonna deselect it. I can't use a traditional scaling method. Now, that is intentional, of course, because what I wanna be able to do is right-click, configure live component. The configuration menu is going to pop up, and I want to use those tools to reconfigure rather than using the standard like scale tool. Now, having said that, if I take this component and I stick it inside of a group, for example, so I'm going to draw a little line here. I'm going to select both those. And I'm going to right click and I'm going to make those into a group. I can come in with scale now and scale those together. So that bigger container is being scaled. The cool thing is that internally, if I come into this group, this is still a live component that I can still configure using my configuration menu, just like it was before. But by putting it inside that container and scaling it, I've made a larger version with the same information. So just a way around it, if you do have a live component that looks good, but the only thing you have to do is you need to change the size of it, just throw it in a group. And you'll be able to do that. All right, so get rid of that line. All right, the other thing is, or the next thing, not other, there's a couple things we got going still, is if I make a copy, even though this is called a live component rather than a standard component, it is still a component. So if I look at the definition of these two pieces, the definition is the same. They're both called toilet. And if I select one of them, and I bring up my live component configuration menu and make a change. So say for example, I push the cistern up higher or something like that. I'm gonna go ahead and change that. And look, both of them are going to change when I do that because they're components and because they are connected. If I wanna make this one separate from this one, I do have to right click on it and I have to hit make unique. Making it unique doesn't change the fact that it's still a live component, but it does separate the tie between these two, sever the tie between these two. So if I load the configuration menu now, after I've hit make unique on the second one, I can edit this using the same configuration. So I can bring that right back down to zero. It doesn't change that other one though. So make unique actually keeps it a live component, but makes it its own. Okay, so next thing I wanna look at is I'm gonna make another copy over here. I'm going to again make this one unique and I'm going to right click and say detach definition. By detaching definition, I've severed the tie that everything that makes this a live component is not in this. So if I click on this one right here, still live component, still the configure button right here, now it's just a component, no configure button. It is a component, so if I was to copy this over here and then, you know, double click, come in here, and I don't know, maybe I'll, if I raise the lid or something like that, see the copy does it too. So it is working like a regular component, but it doesn't have that live component piece anymore. So here we have our original live component. Here we have a unique live component. Here we have it broken down into just a component. Let's go one step further. So these are, if you look at this, as I click between these two, these are the same definition. So I'm going to grab this one and again, a third time, make unique. And once I do that, I can actually come in here and I can start exploding. So as I explode, there we go. You can see now I have each of my separate pieces, so I could do whatever I want with this thing now. So if I wanted to do something like take this lid and raise it up and then grab this piece and scale that up to the bottom of that, I could do that. I could take my lid here and I could, you know, flip that partially open and then grab this piece and do the same thing here. Basically at this point, you know, the toilet is my oyster. I can do whatever I want with this because now it's just a regular SketchUp model. So just a real quick review. Here we have a live component. Here we have a unique live component separate from the beginning, the first one. Here we have a unique component because we broke it apart from here. And over here, we actually have a collection of groups totally broken apart from any componentization of any kind. So those are the things I think about when I think about using a live component inside of a model. Like I said, live components are awesome. They are amazing. The ability to configure that geometry, super cool. Love the sliders and the text being able to put in there, but it's not always exactly what you want and there are changes you might have to make. And these are the kinds of things you're gonna wanna think about when you get to that point. Did you like that video? If so, click like down below. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. We create several videos every single week and you'll be notified of each and every one of them if you subscribe. Most importantly though, please leave a comment down below. Most, if not all, of our content is created based on comments from viewers just like you. We like making these videos a lot, but we like them even more when they're showing something you want to see. Thank you.